Hello everyone. Today I will talk about a program like RStudio. This program is rightfully considered one of the best data recovery software today. Supports all file systems, including Linux, and allows you to recover files both on local logical and physical hard drives, and on drives located on remote computers over a computer network. Network Edition 8.15. The most important, what files can be installed by this program? Those files that were deleted outside the recycle bin or when the recycle bin was emptied. Then those files that were deleted by a virus attack or there was a power failure and they disappeared after the partition with the files was formatted, and even if the partition. Another partition of the file system is formatted also when the partition structure on the hard disk was damaged or damaged also hard disks on which there are a large number of damaged sectors. Which does not start and is difficult to read. So, let's start the installation. I will leave the download link in the description of the video. Here is the RStudio Network Edition folder. There are three files here. Let's run this repack, so look carefully at where to put which checkboxes. There is a choice. Standard installation or unpacking the portable version. We will install the standard one. Click Next. Help the project. Means continue the installation, then the installation folder can be changed, we cannot me further, and also an RStudio icon will be created. Next, install additional interface languages. We choose if we need it. Create desktop icon. After installation, you can immediately launch the program. Visit the project website. Let's remove the checkbox. Click Next. Installation in progress. So, we installed the program. The RStudio icon appears. Next, I prepared a test flash drive. There are four files on it. One format TXT picture PDF and Word document, they are all readable text and PDF and Thieves document and it opens what we will do, we will delete all these files, four files, and our basket is empty. Then we'll try to restore them, you know, launch the program and we select the disk that we want to install, that is, we can immediately scan, show files, search for partitions if we know that everything is in order with the media, and then we do so. But it's best to work with an image. First, create an image. This is very relevant if there are a large number of damaged sectors on the disk. Then work with the image to eliminate the possibility of deterioration of the disk and so create an image. You can make it uncompressed, you can compress the compression level, the size automatically, and where to save it, we will save it to the root of disk C. Default and make an image. Creating an image depends on the size of the hard drive, but I have a flash drive and... a rather small volume of 375 gigabytes, that is, as if I had this image. Done quite quickly, but if the entire hard drive is in operation, this can take quite a long time, but I repeat, to prevent further damage to the hard drive if it is no longer working then. It's better to create an image and then work with it. If we are confident in its functionality, we can scan immediately. The image was successfully created in about 5 minutes, 4 gigabytes of the flash drive, which means we can turn off our flash drive and continue to work. Thus, we have the image highlighted, open the image of ours, and click open, then we have a button like scan, select our image open. Click scan here, there are settings to scan the entire disk or scan area, where we can set the size, but this is useful if we have a very large disk. Further file system, if we don't know which file system, if we know we can specify specifically, if not we leave it as it is, search for known file types. That is, all types of files that are here on the system, you can also remove the checkbox. It will search for all files by Vitsky extensions not to scan us. Not very interested in additionally, we also click scan. Scanning from an image is already much faster than creating the image itself literally. In a few seconds of about 30, the image was created in 5 minutes 35 seconds and scanning in 23 seconds and so on. Recognized 849 megabytes, there is a button to show files. Recognized, select the largest one, here it is, and click show files, which means before we restore we can. Go through to see what is in these folders, if it makes sense to restore, that is the icon. With a red cross shows us something that will be impossible to install, that is, the file is very bad. These are all the files that were found and search process, but were deleted earlier, that is, if in the disk panel we select recognized one or partition one. Here it shows us all the files that we deleted. 24th, 12th. And we see that they have a size. Let's choose them.
I deleted 4 files in particular.
Here's another Daddy Shampoo photo river. Let's try it was deleted much earlier and now click restore the room indicate. Which folder to restore? Basically, we'll create a folder 1 on drive C and here we'll try to restore everything. Selected a folder. There are some settings here. Recover meta files. Open local folder when finished. Alternate data streams are restored. Security attributes are restored. Extended attributes are restored. Files with bad sectors are skipped. This means we put a checkbox here. If our files are not readable, that is, we are restoring from a bad hard drive or from bad media, just click now until recovery. Finished now, let's see that here are the 4 files that we deleted. Now we will check them, the texts read. The picture was also perfectly restored. The PDF file can also be read in the entire Word document and the file also stopped. This folder was deleted earlier today and yet the data was restored. This means that the data recovery program was successful. The only thing is that recovery is more successful. There are more chances to recover information if you delete it. Random information or something happened to the media and after that it did not work. That is, let's say you didn't write information onto the flash drive several times, you need to immediately try to install information in this way rather than using it. And then the chances of recovery are much greater. Once again, I repeat that the Studio is one of the best programs for recovering data and files of all types.